This final featured two seriously good teams. North Shore were regular top four finishers in white ball formats, having had real success in T20. The previous season, they lost out to Suburbs in the semi-finals in a bowl-off after the game was tied. And in the season before that, had beaten Tacker away to be crowned T20 champions. Howick were equally a powerhouse team, with six aces amongst their ranks. They would go on and win the Headley-Howarth two-day competition, and in the group stages had put on scores like the 270-odd for five against Ellerslie, courtesy of a Glenn Phillips 150, and had chased down Cornwall's 199 in the semi-final, scoring 205 for two in 18.4 overs. Either way, these were two form teams, confident with match winners on either side. And for many of the spectators and players alike, this final would go down as one of the greatest in club history.
Obviously, for club players, this was a new experience being on the outer oval at Eden Park. So it was important for us to just let the nerves settle a little bit, have a look at who we were coming up against. Pakuranga team was full of quality in Matt McEwen, Donovan Grobler, Jamie Brown, all aces players. They also had Dunroo Ferns, Glenn Phillips, Mitch McLennan, Colin Munro. So they really did have an all-star team. The team they went with on the day was the team that had done most of the damage. We knew that on a small ground, once you settled in, there would be opportunities to score. And I think the feature in that opening power play was potentially the nerves got the better of Howick than they did us. We didn't do a lot that was fancy, but there was probably four sets of four leg byes that kept the run rate ticking over. I was quite fortunate that two balls in that over just fell into space, and perhaps also that Jamie Brown was at short third man. The big man didn't quite get there. Gus, yeah, giving himself a little bit of room and being bold, he'd batted beautifully up to that point.
Our batting innings got off to a great start. I think we were going at 8 or 9 and over for the first 10 overs there, which is a great platform to be able to compile runs on and put scoreboard pressure on a very good Howick side. And that's what was our goal at the start of the game, is to put scoreboard pressure on.
Mike had done a great job for us throughout the season. He played some crucial innings, getting us home in the semi-final. He was massively important. And in a few quite low-scoring tight games, he just held his head and played good cricket shots to really contribute to team wins. At this stage, we were 101 for two after 12, and we had a platform. And as it turned out, the moment that we were going to try and accelerate, the Howick captain, Bill Walsh, decided to bring himself on. And with the two right-handers, short, straight boundary, it was definitely an over that we'd look to target. And fortunately, a few came off. So we found the middle. He ended up bowling, you know, into an area that I was able to put a few boundaries away, and that over went for 20, which was a great bit of acceleration through the middle.
It was a game that was taken total control of by our pro, Graham Bagan, and he put up what was seriously one of the best T20 performances I think you'll ever see.
For Graham to bring his 100 up in a final at Eden Park in front of a packed crowd was something pretty special to watch. Innings was pretty flawless, and I think that's what set us up to go on and win the game and gave us that belief that we were needing.
Thinking towards the back end was, with the quality they had at the finish, I wanted to take responsibility to be there towards the end, and I thought that I would be in the best position to score off McEwen and Grobbelaar as they closed out the innings. It played off because the last ball of the innings went for six, and for us that turned out to be quite a big difference.
First over, pretty nervous here, to be honest. It's which isn't something I often get bowling, because you obviously get more than one opportunity if you do get whacked, but T20 final Eden Park was pretty big. Did have a little bit of confidence on my side with 186 on the board, though. I was pretty confident that I'd have to go pretty hard pretty early, which I was hoping, as long as I could get into the right areas, would play into our hands a little bit.
In our power play, we went with three overs of left-arm orthodox, Ronnie, Matt Strain, and Ronnie again, and then on the other end we had Brunger, Gus McKenzie, and Brunger again to finish the power play. Slowness of the wicket just made Duncroft very, very effective. He really accurate, bowled a lot of change-ups.
What kind of worried me at first was that he had taken the first ball off a really good length. So it kind of threw what I could replicate in terms of hitting my best length, which is always my go-to. If I'm hitting my length, I'm usually doing something well and being economical. So For to be taken off a good length first up is was a bit, you know, I had to bounce back, and I didn't. Yeah, it was once I kind of got to here, it felt like I was really under pressure, and usually you know how to get out of it. In this case, I felt like I was struggling for options, because he was taking away my best ball and I wasn't confident in landing it at the same time.
These sixes were massive. They were flying out of the park.
I was actually the one at Cal, and those balls were just flying well over my head. And it certainly added another aspect to the game where we felt like we were on top for a large part of their batting innings, and it seemed like within the space of an over or two that quickly swung the other way.
Yeah, so that's where I kind of had a thought to myself, and I actually started bowling with a slightly wider arm. Mm-hmm. So that allowed me to kind of sling the ball in a bit, and I found that length.
Looking back a few years late now, in the context of the game, it was sort of petering out, and this was the spark that just ignited what was to become an unbelievable game of cricket.
I didn't think they were going to take any too bigger risks in this middle over after just hitting 50 off two overs or whatever it was. So I thought, again, as long as you can bowl in the right areas, then, you know, they'd be happy with going for sort of, you know, 8 or 10 or whatever. They'd feel like that was a win. I didn't think they were going to take any stupid risks. But it was, yeah, a bit of a bonus one to get Matty McEwen because he can certainly clear the fence. So I was, yeah, happy with that. Just prior to this over, I remember, obviously, it's a funny game, cricket, where the momentum had just completely shifted into how it packs hands. But, Skipper Graham came up and said words I remember that put me at ease, which was just simply, said, mate, if you were to have accepted 18 at the start of this game, would you take it? And I just remember thinking, yeah, absolutely. 18 off the last over, that's a decent nudge to defend. So I was pretty happy with that, and I was always going one place here. I knew that if I could just hit the hole and hit relatively wide hole with Grobs, I think we'd seen him pretty much hit every ball to the leg side for six, so I thought wide hole would be a pretty good option. Managed to execute that a couple of times, which was happy about. And that was part and parcel of this run out here, which was great bit of work from both Graham and Wallo behind the stumps, sharp as ever. Have to go with a little send off, of course. Guys just struck at about 220. So from there, to be honest, I made a massive mental error here. I really checked out. I was like, I think it was 10 off two balls, thought absolutely no way. And then that happened. I thought there's no one just comes out and hits the six off their first ball, and by God, did he what? So then I really had to switch on again. Try and find that hole, missed it, but fortunately it was low enough. Saw that bat twist in his hand, and just knew that something wasn't quite right, that it wasn't quite going to make it. Once again, had to go straight to the crowd for a little send off, I guess, after some pretty niggly comments on the sideline the whole game. It was cool to see not just how much it meant to all the players, but how much it meant to all the older boys that are associated with the club as well, both throughout the whole match and then afterwards, and then going back to the bar afterwards and seeing how much it meant to everybody was pretty special. So just a pretty special day, and one I won't forget, that's for sure.